Hey, what's up, guys? So recently we posted on Facebook how we stack our inflatables on these pallet racks. It's been really a lifesaver. We started out standing them up in our storage here, but then we found that you could really use the space a lot better by using the height of the warehouse. So a lot of you guys had questions as to how we get them in and out. I want to show you guys how we do that. So first of all, we put them on these pallets. We got these from Harbor Freight, and I like these because unlike your traditional pallet, I could fit three of them on here. And we try to kind of get smaller inflatables that can fit here. We do have some large stuff that's out right now. But so these we got from Harbor Freight. I can get the dimensions. I think they're like 32 by 46. I'd have to double check. But what's cool is you could fit three of them on one shelf. And they're pretty awesome. They're plastic. You could use them both ways. So that's what we use to put them on here. On the floor, these floor dollies have been really awesome. So I can literally just one hand, one finger actually, I can just get these in and out. So, no back breaking. It's been really, really, really helpful here. So I'm going to show you guys how we get them in and out real quick. So we have this electric forklift. We got this on an auction. It's a Crown brand. We got it for fairly cheap, but it did need some work. So we did find the manufacturer that was on here. And it turns out this was actually used by a Target. So they came out, they serviced it. We got it for like $800, and then we spent maybe another $2,000 on it for repairs and oil changes and stuff like that. And now it's good as new. So I like it because it doesn't take up a lot of space. It's electric, so it doesn't need like the propane tanks or anything. It's not too fast. And basically, turn it on. And go like that. And we can just get it out. Voila. So, I mean, obviously, one that's this small, most of the time we just pull it out and drop it. But to get it back up, we don't have to hurt our backs getting it on there. We just throw it on a pallet and put it back in there. And then I continue. So we use these, this tape here. So we use different color caution tape. Green is clean. Right here, I'll show you guys the different colors we use. So when our guys bring stuff back, green is clean. Yellow is dirty. Red is damaged and blue is wet. So they can use multiple ones. But this just kind of helps us get an idea of if it's yellow, then we should probably maybe deliver or actually take the time to actually deep clean it. Just to kind of give us an idea. We go through the warehouse. And we kind of look to make sure to see how many yellows we have or which ones actually need to get out and deep cleaned. A lot of our cleaning we actually do at the customer's house. So our policy is we clean when we deliver and we clean when we pick up. They stay pretty clean. So we don't have to blow up every single unit at the warehouse during the week. With that, we take these markings and they kind of really help us just kind of stay on top of stuff. So I'll put this back and I'll show you guys real quick actually. So this is how we mark our, if you look up here, we have markings. We use these magnets to kind of show us what unit is, and this tells us what the name of the unit is. It's up. This L here is the size of the tarp that we use. Yes, we tarp. So this tells us that we need a large tarp for this. It's a combo, so we want to cover the slide and the entrance. And then this color here is actually the blower, so we color code our blowers. I'll show you guys that. So blue is 2. We use zip ties. So blue is a 2 horsepower. Pink is 1.5. And yellow is what do you call it? 1. And we have over here, actually, it's pretty crappy, but so we have the 2 horsepowers in blue, the 1.5s are pink, and then the yellow is supposed to be here. But our guys got it by now, so we just kind of put a color dot right here, and they kind of know. It's also on our loading list, etc., from our booking software, but we kind of color code each one. So that's how we do it. It's been working out pretty great for us. Hopefully you guys learned something.